I know the thing about memories. There are those that remember, and there are those that is learning how to remember. What to remember on a cold day. Of the cold walls and all activities. Think about my old grandpap, thinking about coming home to us, you know, on the cold day. A World War I. Then there were the days of World War II. But the cold days of the making of the wars. And all of the war's activity is going out for you warriors, warriors and warriors and warriors. And those that was, hey, learning from the rumors of war now on the cold day of war. So many tears had to fall. So many years had to pass away on the cold day of the Cold War. See, I got down to the seconds that humans had to bear. They had to bear the condition. They had to recondition all the ways of thinking. They had to rebuild. They had to bury those that had been killed. My, and oh my, they had to bury all the material. They had to recycle and reuse. They had to reinvent. My, to help reality on the cold day. On the cold days of the cold wars. And here it is, we want to play with wars like we was playing with our toys, like they was gonna be, hey, hey, hey. Disposed of so easily from our memory. I remember the old lady say, watch out, because something's a come back to haunt you. And watch what you're digging, because you first need to plant for something to really grow. She told me, take care of yourself, my child. Be careful as you go life's way. United Kingdom, from here all around the world, on the cold days of war now, things could get colder before they even get hotter, but things could get hotter even in the cold days of war. If you all are troubled about our what's and our where's and who did it, our what's and our where's and who did it, and to think about my old grandfather and my father back in the days of the cold war now, doing the war. I know a lot of children all over the planet now, by the way of digital, saying what? What about this and what about that? What about the time that has passed away? It was about the who's and the what's, y'all. That was in the midst of this earth going around, this mothership, a greater ship than we all grew up on, was doing all the what's for the whoever, to the whoever degree, yeah. As I look across this line, just to think about the humans that must have treaded daily to walk this way. Just seeing all of the what's now that used to be. (Laughs) children is all about the who's and the what's. What have we done to the who? Did we give them a chance to be understood? The who's and the what's. The what for and the how comes. I remember just being a little bitty baby. When the Queen of these United Kingdoms took the throne, I was just 2 years old. When King George passed away, but so much had to be done to protect humanity. I remember the Cold War. I remember a gentleman walking around. His name was Churchill, you know. A little while ago, it was like I was climbing a hill, trying to sing it for real, trying to make us understand that we're living on an earth, of continuation of the who's and the what's. That will yet be coming along. Kingdom and queendom, kingdom and queendom, after kingdom and queendom. We will be the who's of the what's, and the what's from the who. Without you, what will we do? See if I could just tell about all the youth that have came along and left so much of reality, yeah, for us to see. Without you, what will we do? What will there be for us to learn about? What would be our historical information? Y'all may not want to hear what I have to sing. without you. No matter what the weather, hey, we're on this planet together. Oh, with the circulation of the elements now, without you, you. Where will we be in the formulation of the formula of life is continuation, continuation, but without you. Without what some of us call love, the sun shining deep off in space from above, the moon glowing and the stars showing, oh, during the night without you, you, yeah. My, what will I learn to do? What will I, human, learn to do? Thought smithing and learning just to be human, as humanly as we can be, yeah. Let's get beyond wars and wars and rumors of wars, because war doesn't do anything any good. It kills so much around us. You all don't see the little bitty thing that war may kill. You don't see the fragments of war floating in the air. After wars are over, my, without you, what would I be singing to? What would I be singing? What's the name? Leaving the nest now, I'm leaving all the memory. Three. like the bells are ringing. The birds are singing, and us, the humanity's a building, 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 and building. Oh, creating. First three age futuristically, our destination, destinations I've been dreaming. Oh, I've been dreaming. Footsteps, footsteps along the way. Humans are moving. With every situation in mind, I've been dreaming. Oh yes, leaving this nest now. My, as I looked across the shingle, I told my friends, I said, zillions and zillions and zillions, oh, are there for us to see as I leave the nest, leave the nest.
The sea is at peace with the humans, and the humans should be at peace with the sea. As I look toward the sea, in memory of those that worked it hard, worked it so hard here to come up with futuristic events that will take us on to outer space. I believe I'll lay down. I believe I'll take myself a nap. Some people call it sunbathing. If these stones been sunbathing all this long time, then I'm going to sunbathe with the stones. I'm Lonnie Bradley Holley Sr., an African-American artist, saying thumbs up for Mother Universe. Saying thumbs up for Mother Universe.